Hey, welcome to The Student Architect. My name is Chelsea, and today I'm going to show you a quick, easy, and free way to track your hours when you're freelancing. And we're going to use Google Sheets. So when I first started freelancing a few months ago, I was actually tracking my hours by hand in a notebook. And I have proof. Trust me, it didn't take very long until I realized that it was a terrible idea and that I needed a better way to track my hours. So I looked online to try to find quick and easy free ways to do it, and I couldn't find anything that really fit the mold of what I was looking for. So what I decided to do was create my own template for documenting my own hours so that I could track individual hours per day, get the total hours per week, per project, and the total amount that was due for the invoice. And that's really all that I wanted, but I couldn't find any free solutions out there. So I'm going to show you the template that I made, how to do it. First, I'm going to show you how to make the template. Then I'm going to show you where you can download it if you don't feel like going through this whole process. And then finally, I'm going to show you what I'm using now to document my not only my hours, but also my expenses, which I realized was really important now that tax season is coming around, or quarterly taxes. So if you're on board for this, then come join me for the tutorial on how to make your own template. So we'll hop on over to the computer now, and we're going to go on to our Google Drive account. So now that we're in Google Drive, we'll go to New and Google Sheets. So I already have a template created, so I'll just click on this here. And here you can see the finished product. So you can see it has your name, your company name, it has what the invoice is for, the date issued, and of course the documentation of all of the hours per day, weekly hours per month, and then the total. So if this looks good to you, if it looks like something that you're interested in developing or downloading for yourself, then stick around with me and I'll show you how to do it. So now that you can see the template, we're just going to create new, add a new sheet. So we'll start with your name or your company name, if you're fancy like that. We'll say this is a random architect for a random project invoice. And then we'll start with the date, time in, time out, number of hours. And here I'm going to put in a project number, but if you're billing your clients for, if you're doing individual invoices for each project, then you're not going to need this column. But if you have a bulk of hours for different projects on the same invoice, then you'll definitely want this. And then we'll do what tasks that you are working on. Okay. So we'll format this a little bit, but not too much. We're not going to get too much into it. We'll make those a little bit bigger, make it bold. We'll make those bolded. And that's probably all we'll do for right now. So we'll start with week one. And let's see, what was the date at the beginning of this month? Okay, so the first Monday for this billing period was was July 30th. So 7/30/2018. And you can see that it automatically knows that this is a date that you're putting in there, which is awesome. So when you go to put in new dates, all you have to do is click on a calendar instead of having to type in each time the date, each time you have a different date. So we'll select all of those and merge them. We'll bold that. We'll do the same for this. We'll merge those. And now we'll start with our time in. So let's say we started work at 10 a.m. and we ended at 11 a.m. And let's say we did a little bit more work than that. Let's say we did from 10 to 11. We did one task. Let's say that was CD red lines. I don't know what kind of work you do. But yeah. So next we'll say this was some kind of a rendering that we were working on. All right. So now we're into the number of hours. We have our time in here, but our number of hours, we're going to have a little formula. So for this formula, we're going to put in equals parentheses. We're going to select this cell here. We're going to do minus this cell, close the parentheses, and then we'll do times 24 hours. Okay, so it's showing 0 hours right now because we want to set this as plain text, so that'll show us 1 hour, and we will format that a little bit. We want that centered. Let's center those as well. And what we'll do here is we're going to drag this little bottom right-hand corner down where it has that little box, and it'll populate that number down. So it just so happens that this is another 1 hour period. But you can see if we double click on this, it's actually giving us the sum of these hours rather than these hours. So that's good. The computer's pretty smart. So you always want to double check where the formula is getting those numbers from by just double clicking, just to make sure that you're getting your formulas correct. And also when you put in a formula, you won't see it here, but you will see it up here at the function line up there. So let's say instead of 12 o'clock, we finished at 1 o'clock p.m. Oh, but now we have negative 10 hours. Well, that's because this is reading this as a different type of time. This isn't reading it in military time, and it doesn't have the p.m. So what we could do is just change it to p.m. and it could be 1300, or we could just do 1300 hours. So the way that you can set the way that this time works is you can either go to format up here and then do this drop down for the numbers, or you could hit this 1, 2, 3. We could go down to the bottom with more formats, more date and time. You could either do this simple hours and minutes, or in military time, or you could do the regular hour time with AM PM. I prefer to do the military time, so we'll keep it like that. Project number, let's just say 1618. We will control C, control V that, so that we'll copy and paste, rather than if I just drag that box down. Oh, I guess it doesn't do that. Okay, well, usually it would populate the next number, so I was assuming that it would do 1619, but it didn't, because I don't know why. Maybe because I put that as, I don't know. Okay, moving on. So now that we have these things all formatted, all we have to do now is copy and paste for the whole week. Okay. So we'll change the dates here. And again, it's really simple. All we have to do is click the date on the calendar instead of having to type it in every time. And the third. Okay, so this will be week total hours. And here we're going to type in another formula. We'll type in equals sum. And it's pretty cool. It's telling us it'll do an automatic formula for us. But what I want to do is actually do a parentheses and click the individual cells. So we'll click one, we'll hold down control, and then we'll click on the rest of them that we want to add. Oh, we don't want that. Okay, we will. How do you deselect? I guess if you select any by accident, you can just kind of go into the parentheses and delete them. manually. If you have a tip on how to do that, how to deselect a cell, let me know. And we will close the parentheses. Okay, cool. So we had 15 hours that week. That's pretty awesome. So we will merge those. We will reformat that to be right aligned. And great. So now we have one whole week of all of our hours. So what we can do here is actually so we can see this a little bit better. Let's add a little bit of color just so we can see. What am I doing? All right. So now what we're going to do is select all of these. We're going to Control C to copy. Click down here, Control V to paste. We'll just change that to week two. And again, it's a little bit tedious, but you'll just have to click on each individual cell to change the date. But again, you don't have to type it in, which is great. You just have to click on the date. And if you guys know a simple way to copy and paste a sequential order of numbers, if that makes sense, let me know in the comments below if you know a simpler way to do this. So what was this? The 8th, the 9th, and the 10th. Cool. So again, we have our week's total hours, but since we have a formula here, we'll want to check all these formulas, make sure they're doing the right thing. And again, check this formula, and you can see it's pretty smart. Computers are pretty smart. They know not to take information from up here. They know that we want the information here. So good for you, computer. We'll do that a couple more times for the rest of the month. Sure, we'll want to change these. I guess the biggest issue with this is just making sure that you change out the information for each invoice and just make sure that you're changing the dates and making sure that the weeks are in order and all that jazz. And then, great. So we're checking our formulas, making sure that they're all good. Then at the bottom here, we'll put in total hours. And we'll put in another formula, equals sum, open parentheses. And this time, we're just going to click on the week total hours. So we're not clicking on the individual days, we're clicking on the weeks. And to select multiple, we're just holding down control. And we'll hit OK. All right, so we had 60 hours that month. That's pretty good. And now we'll do amount due. So we'll do another formula. That one is equals sum. And this time we'll just click on the total hours times whatever your hourly wage is. So if you're awesome and you're getting $100 an hour, we'll put that in there. And that's $6,000 for 60 hours of work. You're doing pretty good. So we'll center that. And you'll see that it's just showing 6,000. It's not showing us dollars yet. So what we want to do is go back up to that 123 here. And we'll just say, we'll format that for accounting. So that'll show us the cents as well. Because if you're putting in quarters of hours or half hours, you're going to want to get those extra pennies. And that's pretty much it. It's pretty simple. It's a pretty basic way to track your hours. But when I was first starting out, it was essential for me. It was a huge step up from documenting everything in my notebook, which was just it was an archaic way of documenting my hours. But this is great if you're just starting out and you just want to get an idea of what kind of hours that you're spending on different projects and just keeping better track of your time management. If it's not for freelancing and maybe it's just for your own needs, then this is a great way to track your hours. And so if you've made it this far and you don't want to do all the work, you can always go to thestudentarchitect.studio/guides, where you can download a copy of the template that I've made, which I showed you at the beginning of the video. And I've cleaned it up for you a little bit, so don't worry about that. And so you can customize it any way that you want. You can change the colors, you can add and remove columns and all kinds of stuff. You can make it really whatever you want, but I just wanted to give you a starting point that you could work off of. And it's really that simple. That's all it is. It was a great system for me when I started, but now that I have to do taxes and things, I'm realizing that I need a better way to track my expenses and keep better track of my hours. And the way that I do that now is by using Freshbooks. And I'm sure you've heard all of the ads about Freshbooks and how great they are. And I personally never thought that I would need Freshbooks until I did the free trial. And it was so simple to put all of my hours in. They have an hour tracker or a timer. So once you start a project, you just click on the timer. And then once you're finished, it'll just automatically log those hours for you. And that was critical for me to not have to keep track of every second of time that I was spending on projects, because I could just click on the timer and turn it off when I was done. And it did all the work for me. And the same thing with expenses. I had no idea where to start with tracking my expenses, but with FreshBooks, you can upload a receipt or you can have it imported from your bank account, and it just is so simple. But if you're just starting out and you're looking for something free that doesn't cost you any money, this spreadsheet, I think, is the way to go. This was the perfect thing for me when I was first starting out. And if you don't want to go through the trouble of making this whole template yourself, you can go to thestudentarchitect.studio/guides and you can download the template that I've made here. Yeah, I hope you find it helpful. And if you have a better system, please feel free to share that in the comments below. And I may or may not do a blog post on this to show you step by step with screenshots for people that might learn that way a little bit better. So keep a lookout for that. I will probably do that in the next couple of weeks. And I think that's it. I think that's everything that I wanted to go over with you guys. I hope that you found this video helpful. And if you did, please take a moment to subscribe if you haven't already. And hit that like button, because it really helps me out when it shows that a lot of people are liking my stuff. And it helps me know that you like it. You know, it makes me want to keep making more videos. And if you want to contribute to support my work, you can do so at thestudentarchitect.studio/contribute. And I'll keep making more videos because I like doing this for you guys. It helps me help you. So I will see you in the next video. So have a great day. Enjoy making your freelance time tracking a little bit easier. And I'll talk to you next time. Bye.